Hi, I know what you're thinking. I'm just standing in front of my blue screen inside my apartment, and I just digitalized the beach on my back. Well, not today. Today I'm standing in front of the beautiful beach in Gold Coast, Australia, surfer's paradise, my home. Surfer's paradise, a place of unlimited fun and unlimited sunshine that, unlike us, it never gets old. Wouldn't it be awesome to stay young forever so we could enjoy this place to the maximum for hundreds of years? This idea might have been crazy just 10 years ago, but as we get deeper into this century, things have started to change, and the whole idea of staying young for much longer than we're used to is starting to be taken very seriously by many scientists. This is Mickey. He is a little white mouse. His frenetic lifestyle is ruled pretty much by his biology. His heart beats at 750 times per minute, and his metabolic rate is so high that he literally burns himself out. However, this crazy lifestyle is pretty much over within 2 years. Mickey is one of the shortest living mammals in the world. But in those 2 years, he has to live a whole life. He's a father at 3 months, and he's a grandparent at 6 months. So it appears as his program to live and do everything in fast forward. This is Sammy, and he, like many other birds, he is a remarkable creature. Some species of birds can live up to 50 years, but there are some documented cases of birds living up to 70 years, outliving many owners in the process. Birds have a huge lifespan considering their size and compared to mice. On this planet, trees are the only organisms that can live and reproduce for thousands of years. So what's exactly stopping us from living that long? The longest documented lifespan was that of Madame Jacques Clément. She lived 122 years in France. That's pretty long if you ask me, but again, we seem to be bumping with the natural limit of the human life. But now there might be some hope in this department, because we have realized that we're not programmed to age, we're not programmed to die. Our body has genes and DNA and instructions that tells our body how to grow up, mature, reproduce, and that's it. There's no programming to die, there's no programming to get old. However, in reality, we know that every day we get older. Our hair, our skin, our muscles. But why? So what's the problem? For example, this man, his hair used to be black. He had tiny cells that manufactured the black pigment. But as time passed, these cells just stopped making that pigment and his hair turned white. Over time, the collagen framework that supports our skin starts to deform and cells start to produce the wrong protein, so our skin collapses into wrinkles. And the same happens all over our body. So we're aging just because our cells are too damaged to work properly. It is not programmed in, it just happens. There are two types of age, the chronological age and the biological age. Chronological age is plain and simple the number of years you've been living in this planet. Biological age is the age of your body in comparison to the average of the population. So this biological age is the one that you can affect by lifestyle, diet, exercise, etc. So what becomes obvious at this point is that if you really want to get a handle of aging, we need to go down inside us. We have to go to the microscopic level. The latest theory is that all birds have one component in their cells that is really efficient. They are the mitochondria, and all animal cells have them. Then these mitochondria are tiny power stations that pump out energy day and night, and this energy is important for vital functions. The problem is that this mitochondria leaks some particles called free radicals as well. And the free radicals are the ones who damage the cells because they crash into vital DNA information, which is information that tells the cell how to work properly. So when this information gets too compromised because of too much damage, the cells start passing bad information to the daughter or sister cell. That's why over time this information gets too corrupted and the cells don't know how to work properly. And the latest research shows that birds leak 10 times less free radicals than mice, so they age 10 times slower. So what about us? On one hand, we do create free radicals as well that cause genetic damage. But on the other hand, we have fantastic repairing mechanisms, much better than mice, even better than birds. The thing is that even that is not enough. Over time, not all the damage gets repaired, not all the free radicals get soaked in, so we age. As simple as that. So as you can see by now, free radicals is one of the major causes for aging. The thing is that the body not only has to deal with the free radicals that are produced inside our bodies when we produce energy, but also with the free radicals that are in the environment, for example, pollution, and also from bad habits such as smoking, drinking, drugs, etc. But especially smoking is really bad for you. But food can also be a really good tool against free radicals and aging, especially the ones high in antioxidants. Antioxidants are the sworn enemy of free radicals. Antioxidants are your friend. Antioxidants go around your body looking for free radicals, they capture them, and they aid in their elimination. So the more antioxidants that we can consume, the better. There is one important concept we also be familiar with, and that's the ORAC. The ORAC is oxygen radical absorbance capacity. And what it is basically a number that is assigned to every fruit, vegetable, food, etc., according to the amount of antioxidants that they have. So if certain fruit or vegetable has a really high amount of antioxidants in it, the ORAC number associated with it is going to be high. So basically, if you want to stop your biological aging, you need to start eating these ORAC-rich foods. And where are you going to find those? Well, just because I like you guys, just because I really love you guys, I made a research on my supercomputer and I came up with a top 10 ORAC foods that you should be eating.
Number 10!
And number 10 we have broccoli. Broccoli has 890 ORACs and it's great. You can find it anywhere almost all year round and it's delicious. I like it raw, but it's just me, you can steam it, etc.
Number 9!
Brussels sprouts with a score of 980.
Number 8!
Raspberries with 1220 ORACs.
Number 7!
Spinach with 1260 ORACs.
Number 6!
Strawberries with 1540 ORACs.
Number 5!
Kale with 1770 ORACs.
Number 4!
Blackberries with 2036. If you can't find fresh ones, go for the frozen ones.
Number 3!
Blueberries with 2400. Again, if you can't find fresh ones, get the frozen ones.
Number 2!
Raisins with 2830.
Number 1!
And the winner by a big margin, we have prunes with 5770 ORACs. I usually buy these organic prunes bag with 250 grams. Can you guess the ORAC score of this thing?
It's over 9,000!
What 9,000? There's no way that can be right, can it?
Oh, I think it's right. After all, prunes are the king of antioxidants. And not only that, they're high in fiber, no fat, no cholesterol. And get the organic ones so you can have also not treated with sulfur dioxide and no preservatives, which is very important. Look at that. All these guys are full of antioxidants, vitamins, minerals, fiber, etc. They're also delicious and easy to eat. I love them so much, in fact, that I'm gonna give them all the Handsome Carlos seal of approval. In the 21st century, it's really exciting because there's new research, there's new science, and scientists have been able to extend the lifespan of a few animals. For example, they started with yeast cells, they moved to worms, and they moved to mice after that, and they've been able to, but you know, by manipulating and tweaking genes, they've been able to increase the lifespan of these animals from 6 to 10 times. And now this research is being conducted on monkeys, and if it works on monkeys, there's a really good chance that it can work on humans. And there's really optimistic scientists that claim that within the next 40 years, they will be able to produce an elixir of life that will keep humans alive and young for 200, 500, perhaps even 2,000 years, which is staggering in itself. The question is, would you drink it?
The reason I would drink this is because I want to look young forever, and I think it would help with everyone in the world if they could look young, because then everyone would be happy and it would be a better place. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you. What about you?
Yeah, the same. It'd be really good. I'd love it.
Would you mind living for 2,000 years?
Yeah.
That would be awesome, because then you could do
forever.
Yeah, and then you could do more stuff. Like
experience more stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Longer to live is awesome.
I wouldn't drink it, no.
Why?
I think we're all given a certain length of time here, at a certain period of time to enjoy and to experience certain things, and if you were to live beyond that, I just don't think it would be natural.
I concur. Yeah, I concur.
Salud. See you later, guys. This is LifeMatter.ws. My name is Carlos Salazar. Take care.